Welcome back to the session. In the last class, we were discussing about the numericals. We had started solving numericals, right? And I had asked you to make the list of all the new formulas relating to the chapter current electricity, right? So if you have that list of complete list of all the important equations and all the important formulas by knowing the terms which are involved, then it will be easy for you to solve the numericals. Fine. So in this session also, we will continue the same discussion about the numericals. Let's get started. Move to the next question. This is a very important question because this is relating to Kirchhoff rules. Okay. And that rules and numericals relating to it, it's very important for your competitive examination. So if you know how to solve the numerical using those rules step by step in this way, then it will be easy for you to go through the shortcuts and crack the numericals in your competitive exams. So kindly listen to this numerical very carefully. Fine. So the numerical is very simple in sentence. Determine the current in each branch of the network shown in the figure. So they have given a network, of resistor and a cell. In this electrical network, you have to determine the current which is flowing across each branch. Branch, again, our definition already discussed. Maadidivi. Branch andre eno, it is the conducting path between one junction. It starts from one junction and terminates to the another junction. So we have to determine the current across each branch in this electrical network. So very step while solving this numerical is that express the electric current in terms of unknown values. Okay, unknown terms alli first naven maadbeku prati ondu branch alli current yenide adanna naavu barkobeku. Okay, if we write that unknowns, then it will be easy for you to find those unknown values in terms of knowns. Okay. So let's imagine in the circuit, obviously the current will originate from the cell. So cell, they have given potential as 10 volt. Let us assume the current which is originating from the cell, that is given by I, capital I. So the current which is originating from the cell will be the same current which will terminate to the cell. Therefore, the current which is starting from the positive terminal of the battery and ends up to the junction A is capital I, and the current which is reaching the battery from the junction C to the negative terminal is also capital I. Now look at the junction A. At junction A, this current I is entering and it is getting divided into two different paths, right? So at two different paths na nan enanta tagoltini, let us say the current which is flowing through the resistor 10 ohm is I1, and the current which is flowing across this 5 ohm resistor is, since I is the current which is entering the junction, I1 has left in this path, so remaining current across this resistor will be I minus I1. So naven maadbeku yavaglu circuit alli unknowns na barkobekadre, we should always try to take the unknowns as less as possible. ನಾವು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂತ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು ಐ ಐ ಒನ್ ಐ ಟೂ ಐ ತ್ರೀ ಐ ಫೋರ್ ಐ ಫೈವ್ ಐ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ಸ್ ನೀವು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಹಂಗೆ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಟು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಅದೇ ನೀವು ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಂದರೆ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ನ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಏನು ತೊಗೊಂಡಿರ್ತೀರೋ ಅದರಲ್ಲೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದರೆ ಪ್ರತಿ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಚ್ ಹತ್ರ ಅಥವಾ ಪ್ರತಿ ವೈರ್ ಹತ್ರ ಕರೆಂಟ್ನ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದರೆ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಐ, ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಪಾತ್ ಎ ಟು ಬಿ ಇಸ್ ಐ ಒನ್, ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪಾತ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಎ, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೇ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎ ಟು ಡಿ ಏನಿದೆ ಐ ಮನಸ್ ಐ ಒನ್ ಅಂತ ಅಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ನಾವು ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ, ಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ ಹತ್ರ ಏನಿದೆ, ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಐ ಒನ್, and the current which is leaving across two paths are from B to C and B to D. Let us say one among these currents is I2, let I will imagine from B to D the current which is flowing is I2. Then obviously the current which flows from B to C will be I1 minus I2, right? So I1 enter aagta ide adralli I2 current one path inda hogta ide mikkid current en irutte assume 10 ampere current is entering 4 ampere current is flowing through this path remaining current en irutte 10 minus 4 that is 6 ampere right so I can write it as I1 minus I2 current is flowing from B to C now look at the junction D junction D hatra en ide current which are entering are I minus I1 that is entering I2 is also entering now there is only one path from where the current is leaving this junction so the current which will be leaving this junction will be the sum of these two currents because we know according to Kirchhoff junction rule at any junction the algebraic sum of the currents will remain zero and the current is enter aagta idiyo it should leave that junction the same amount of current therefore from this path D to C the current let us assume it is I minus I1 minus sorry plus I2 so this is the amount of current which is leaving this junction D now look at the junction C C hatra nodi observe maadi the current which are entering are I1 minus I2 and I minus I1 plus I2 right if you simplify these two things then the current which is leaving this junction will be capital I I1 and I2 will get cancelled right minus I1 plus I1 will cancel agutte minus I2 plus I2 cancel agutte remaining I is the same current which is entering this negative terminal of the battery which means the way we have distributed the currents in terms of unknown in the circuit is correct okay so once you are done with this the second step is applying the Kirchhoff loop rule okay Kirchhoff voltage law na navu apply martta hogi navu en madbeku we have to simplify for the unknown values I1 and I2 and I value if we determine then we can easily say what amount of current is distributing in each branch now let us applying Kirchhoff voltage law Kirchhoff voltage na KVL antanu barithivi let's apply this loop rule on the first loop that is A B D A so this is the first loop what I am considering so first loop A B D A adana alphabetically il barkoli so that you should remember the calculations okay so when we are applying the loop rules we have to follow the sign convention so what I had already discussed so let's not waste the time in recalling all that directly let's apply the rule so when we are traversing current and we are traversing in the same direction so the equation becomes if the traversing and the current direction are in the same direction then we take the value as positive so let us take it as the potential difference across the first resistor is 10 ohm resistance is 10 current is I1 so R into I na baribeku so I will write it as 10 I1 now we are traversing through B to D travel madbekadre navu travel martiro direction matte current direction enagide eradu same ide so hagagi plus sign tagolana I2 into the resistance what we have come across so 5 into I2 moving further from b to d alli sorry a to b calculation aitu b to d calculation aitu now d to a across d to a again we have come across a resistor now travel martirodu e direction alli upward direction alli but the current which is traveling is in downward direction when the directions are opposite then we should consider a negative sign so negative sign tagondaga enagutta the resistance and current multiplied is 5 into I minus I1 so since we reached the end of the loop that is we started from A we traversed the loop and came to the closed path so our calculation terminates here so this should be equal to 0 okay so further simplifying this idanna matte simplify maadkobeku 10 I1 plus 5i2 minus 5i minus into minus plus 5i1. This is equal to 0. So common terms irodunna separate maadi barkoli. That is 15i1 plus 5i2 minus 5i is equals to 0. If you divide it by 5, since 5 is common in all the three terms, the simplified equation will be 3i1 plus i2 minus I is equals to 0. Let us consider this as our equation 1. So the same steps you have to follow whenever you are applying any voltage law on any loop. In maadbeku, first apply maadkobeku, then adunna simplified form ik togondu, that you have to consider it as an equation. Okay, so that you can use those equations, quadratic equations, and simplify for the unknown values. Okay, so this is our equation 1. Now let us apply the Kirchhoff voltage law. Applying Kirchhoff voltage law for the second loop, that is BCDB. Okay, BCDB means this loop, BCD and B. So this is the second loop I'm considering. B to C, directions are same. We are also traversing downward direction. Current is also in downward direction, which means we have to take the positive value. So resistance any there, 5 either. 5 multiplied by I1 minus I2. Okay. Next, moving further. Now traverse martiro direction, matte current direction opposite there. So take minus sign. Resistance any there, only 10 either. 10 multiplied by the current is I minus I1 plus I2. Moving further in the loop, D to B. Now traverse maartirodu upward direction alli, current flow aagta irodu downward direction alli. So opposite irodrinda, again we have to take it as a negative sign. Resistance here is 5 and current across this resistor is I2. Moving further, it closes the loop. Therefore, this is equals to 0. Idunna simplify maadi niv bardaga. Idunna multiply maadi, aamel simplified formal togon bandu. Positive equation na bardaga. I hope you can easily do it, but I am directly writing that equation. Okay, so 3i1 minus 4i2 minus 2i is equals to 0. So this is, let us consider this as equation 2. Since I have shown here the simple way, adu simple ida calculation, I hope you will do it. So simplify maad bardaga, you will get this equation number 2. Okay, now similarly, let us apply. Since three unknowns we have to find, at least for three loops we have to apply the Kirchhoff voltage law. So let us apply the Kirchhoff voltage law to the loop A, B, C, H, G, A. Okay, what is this loop? I'll just show you. H and G. Look into the diagram. Okay, diagram al nodi. ನಾನೇನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಲೂಪ್ನ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಜಿ ಹೆಚ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಡೌನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ಜಿ ಎ. ಈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಪಾತಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೋ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು, ಕಿರ್ಚಾಫ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಲಾನ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಡೂ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎ ಟು ಬಿ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟ್ರಾವರ್ಸ್ ದ ಲೂಪ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎ ಟು ಬಿ. ಸೊ ಲುಕ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ವೆನ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ ದ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲೆಟರ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಇಫ್ ದ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲೆಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್, ದೆನ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ in which direction we have to flow, it will be easy for you to calculate. Clockwise direction idiyo or anti-clockwise idiyo, that will be easy for you to follow up the direction of the currents as well. So we are starting the direction from A to B. loop ना start ಮಾಡಿರೋದು a to b. So a to b ನಾವು ಟ್ರಾವರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. Direction of the current is also in the same direction. So sign convention ಏನು ತಗೋಬೇಕು? Positive ತಗೋಬೇಕು. So resistance multiplied by current is the potential difference. So 10 into I1. Next, moving further, b to c. B to c direction ಅಲ್ಲಿ downward direction ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. Current ಕೂಡ downward direction ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ. So ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ? Positive sign ತಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ. Resistance there is 5 and the current is I minus I1. Okay, moving further, C to H. Nama loop L hokta ide, C to H hokta ide. Current direction kuda ade direction alli ide, but C to H madhyadalli yavade electrical component present illa. Alli resistor kuda illa, cell kuda illa, so there is no calculation. Okay, moving further from H to G. When we are moving further from H to G, we came across the cell first. Namige ondu cell sikkide. Alli negative terminal we have reached first. If we reach the negative terminal first, then we have to take the sign as positive. And what is the potential difference here? The EMF what they have given is the potential difference. So simply write it as 10. Illi 10 jothe matte current value multiply madadu eno avashyakate illa, because EMF itself is the potential difference. So simply write 10. Moving further in the loop, if we came across, moving further, we came across the resistor, right? Again, if we look at the direction of the current, current direction is in same direction as we are traversing, so positive sign. So since it's a resistor, we have to multiply the current to get the potential. So 10 into I, capital I. Moving further in the loop, G to A. Since there is no component, resistor kuda illa, cell kuda illa, so no calculation. Then since we have reached A, it completes our loop. Therefore, the calculation terminates here. So after this, what we have to do? Simplify madkobeku. Terms na separate maadi, simplify maadi barkobeku. Simplify maadi bardaga, common terms tagondo, you will get an equation as 3i1 minus i2 plus 2i is equals to 2. Okay, so this value you will get. Let us consider this as equation number 3. Iduna simplify maadidaga ee equation sigutte. Okay, I hope you understood. So my next calculation step eno, four equations na tagondideve to determine the three unknowns. So let's just simplify this. Let's adding equation 2 and equation 3. Equation 2 matte 3 na add madana. Okay. So in any ways you can simplify the quadratic equations as you have learnt in mathematics. This is the simplest way I am trying to explain you. So here two equations add madbekandre, write the those equations 3i1 minus 4i2 minus 2i is equals to 0 plus 3i1 minus i2 plus 2i is equals to 2. Whenever we are adding the equations, you know mathematically we don't change any signs. So this minus 2i and plus 2i gets cancelled. 6i1, adding these two things, we get minus 5i2. This is equals to 2. So let us say this is our equation number 4. Fine. So further en madana, let us simplify this equation 1 and equation 2. Equation 1 and equation 2 na add madidre, let us see if any term gets cancelled, right? The term will get cancelled. E2y cancel agutte when we will multiply a term called 2 to this equation and then add it to the equation number 2. Therefore, what I'll do multiplying. Let's multiply equation 1. Equation 1 na nave en madana, 2 numerical inda multiply madana, and then I will add it to the equation 1 so that I can cancel a term and simplify it further. Okay, so multiplying 2 to this equation, it gives equation 1 ige now multiply madidre en sigutte namage, 6i1 plus 2i2 minus 2i is equals to 0, and equation 2 na as it is barkobeku. 3i1 minus i2 plus 2i is equals to 0. Now, since again we are adding, no signs will change. This term will get cancelled. So, remaining terms are 9i1 plus i2 is equals to, sorry, this is 2, right? Is equals to 2. Or you can rewrite it as i2 na beku andre i2 is equals to 2 minus 9i1 anta barkabodu. Let us say this is our equation number 5. Fine. Now, looking at the equations 4 and 5. 4 and 5 observe madidre. If I substitute the value of i2 from equation 5 in equation 4, then I can calculate what is the value of i1. Right? So, therefore, I'll substitute the value, substituting equation 5 in equation number 4. So, substituting what we get? 6i1 minus 5 into i2 jagdal naveen madbeku ee value na substitute madbeku. So, 2 minus 9 into i1 is equal to 2. Idanna simplify madkoli. 6i1 minus 5 2s are 10 minus 5 9s are 45i1. So, this is equals to 2. Or further simplifying this, we get 51 into i1 is equals to 12. E 10 na right hand side ikthagondre negative term becomes positive. Or if I want the value of i1, this is simply is equals to 4 divided by 17 ampere. Or you can also express it in decimals as i1 is equals to 0.235 ampere. So, one value of the unknown current is been determined. One current na navu find out madkonvi. Now, if one current is determined, easily we can determine the other two currents as well. Right? So, other two values yavriti find out madkobodu. Obviously, the second current we can find by substituting this value of i1 in equation number 5. So, let's just substitute it. Let's not wait and substitute it. Substituting i1 value. Substituting i1 in equation number 5. So, it gives you i2. i2 is equals to 2 minus 9 multiplied by 0.235 ampere. So, idanna simplify madbarudre eshtu barutte? You get 0.1176 amperes. So, i2 value is 0.1176 amperes. So, this is i2. Now, i1 value is also known, i2 value is also known. Now, we have to determine i value, right? That is the third unknown. Third unknown na find out madkolake, which equation we can use. Check out the equations in which I is consisting. I equation yadra lide, equation 2 alide, equation 3 alide, equation 1 alide. Since it's simplest one, let's consider equation 1. Okay, equation 1 na togolana. So, let's just highlight the value of i2. Okay. Now, from equation 1. Equation 1 any there? So, equation 1 is I is equals to 3i1 plus i2. So, equation 1 in the nan I value ge barkondidini. I1 and i2 value are already known. So, just substitute those values. 3 into 0.235 plus 0.1176. So, simplifying this, you get I is equals to 0.588 ampere. So, this is the I value. So, all the three unknown currents we have determined. Now, the answer is, since we have determined it, does this completes our numerical? Then the answer is no. We haven't yet reached the answer, because what we are supposed to find, we have to determine the current in each branch of the network. We have just calculated I, I1 and I2. but in different branches you can see it is not the current which is flowing, only I1 and I2 and I, right? In between A to D, it's I minus I1, right? So that we have to calculate. Between B to C, it's I1 minus I2 that we should calculate. Between D and C, it's I minus I1 plus I2 that we must calculate. Only these branches, that is A, G, H, C and A, B and B, D. These currents we have determined, but rest of the three currents yet to be determined, right? So let's determine those currents. So current in DC, as you have seen in the diagram, current in DC is I minus I1 plus I2, right? Just substitute all the values. So it gives you, if you write it in fractions al barkondre idene irutte. So this, when you simplify this, this will give you some value of minus 2 by 17, right? And this I value will be somewhat 10 divided by 17. Simplification maadbekadre nimige ee value sigutte, ade values alna illi substitute maadi fractions less express madana. I value is 10 divided by 17 minus 4 divided by 17 plus of minus 2 divided by 17. So if you simplify this, you get 4 divided by 17. 4 divided by 17 ampere. It's nothing but what? In decimals, the value is 0.235 amperes. And one more current we had to find, that is current in AD, right? From A to D, we know the current which is flowing is I minus I1. So I value is 10 divided by 17 minus I1 value is 4 divided by 17. So this gives you 6 divided by 17, that is 0.352 amperes. You'll get some more decimal points, but this much is enough. So next, one more current what we had to calculate is current across the branch, current in BC, right? So that was I1 minus I2. I1 value is 4 divided by 17 and I2 value is minus 2 divided by 17. So this is equals to 6 divided by 17 ampere. So that is almost similar to the branch AD. So that is 0.3529 ampere. Okay. So these are the current distribution across each branch, right? So one interesting thing you must note, when you simplify this, you'll get a negative value. Negative current magnitude will not be in negative. Okay, current value negative agiralla. That negative is signifying what? It is just telling you the direction. It might be that when you are drawn the direction for the current I2 direction na e direction al hakirtivi, but in actual thing the direction of the current might be in opposite direction. So that negative sign is indicating just that the magnitude of the current is flowing in opposite direction. And one more thing what you should remember is, so how to, you can verify, once you have determined all these currents, you can verify it by applying the Kirchhoff junction rule. Yadadru and junction hatra ni junction rule na apply maadi, by substituting these current values, if you get the sum of the current is equals to zero, then the values what you have found is absolutely correct. Okay, so this is how you can apply the Kirchhoff rules on any electrical network. This is a simple one which they have given. Okay, in the same manner, you can use the rules, simplify the equations and identify the unknown values. Unknown currents na nivu ee rithi determine maadabodu.